Okay.
Well, we got some great questions today. Clarence writes, she says, Pat, if you have a neighbor who is selling and all of his customers are in your apartment building, selling drugs rather, should you report this activity to the authorities for the sake of the young children in the building?
I don't know if there's any question you ought to report it. If you see a crime being committed as a citizen, you have an obligation to report it. But you've got to ask the police to leave you anonymous, because otherwise the drug dealers will come after you, and the next thing you know, you wind up dead, and that's not too good. But you have to have an ironclad agreement with the police that they won't use your name, and they can develop their own investigation and their own evidence, not using you.
Right. All right, a viewer writes, whenever my parents fight, my dad threatens my mom with his gun. Fortunately, this now means nothing to my mom, and she never goes nuts about it. She's very calm. But as a child, I get nervous and worried when this happens. Even my younger brother saw the incident. What should we do about it and him?
Well, again, you don't want to get your father busted, but you could.
Might be what he needs.
Well, misuse of a firearm, but you ought to go to your mother and say, Mom, this thing is scaring me, and I ask you, please, to get my father to have some help. This kind of rage, I mean, one day he's going to pull the trigger. It doesn't take too much. If you've got a loaded weapon and you're brandishing it around, I'm going to kill you, and the next thing you know, the thing goes off. Maybe accidentally, but the mother will wind up dead. Mm. You need to do something to intervene, but you're a kid. What do? You know? No. Your mother ought to take care of that.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, Sharon writes, she has a question for you, Pat. Do you wear a helmet while riding your horse? Do you only do dressage, or do you ride Western style as well?
I used to do hunter jumper. That's what I did most of the time. This dressage has come late for me. But with a hunter, you want a helmet, because if you fall off on your head, it hurts. Most dressage riders don't really have a helmet. They wear those little pork pie hats, because the chances of a dressage horse bucking you off is kind of
slim. And this is dressage, what we're looking at here?
This is dressage, which means training, and
That is so beautiful. The way
that's called a half pass, and he's doing it at a canter. He's a wonderful.
Now, do you speak to him, and do you say half pass?
Oh, I talk to him. Yeah, I say we're going to do a half pass to the right and everything. It's flow. He feels you looking. That's a pirouette.
You know, I have only been on a horse a few times, but when you get there, you're galloping. That to me is the most fun, you know, but it's kind of scary.
Well, with him it is, because you run across that ring at full speed. Now, this is, that's a sort of a passage. He wasn't come up to him. That's more of just an extended trot. Not an extended trot, but just a working trot right there. But he's 17-3 hands. If you fall off on your head, it'll hurt. But I wear a helmet. But the classical dressage riders just wear that little pork pie hat. They don't wear.
Have you ever fallen off?
Sure.
You got back on.
Well, I was training a thoroughbred to jump, and the thoroughbred didn't want to jump and came up to this little X and stopped.
Oh.
And I kicked her, and all of a sudden she launched like she was going to jump the moon, and she took off and leapt high in the air, and I wasn't prepared for it, and I went off.
It's beautiful to watch, I've gone Pat. Off. Very impressive. Well, if you'd like to see more dressage with Pat and Ufano, just log on to CBN.com. You can check out the entire video there. Well, we've got another question. Doris writes, my child has Down syndrome. He's 50 years old with the mind of a 3-year-old. I've always thought that God left me here to care for him, but I'm getting old and soon will not be able to care for him. Will God forgive me? Will he hold me accountable if I give up and send him to his sister to care for him? Or should I continue to rely on God for help?
I think send the child to the sister and take care of him. That's a noble thing. I'm surprised that a child with that that syndrome has lived to 50.
Yeah.
But what a burden it has been on you. You are a noble person to have had a caring, loving relationship with that child over these years. And of course, the Lord would not hold you guilty if you pass that child on to a sister, because you will be dying, and what's going to happen after you die? So you're looking after him in advance. It's a loving thing. I mean, God will bless you for it. All right.
All right. Austin writes, I love the 700 Club, and I won't stop watching the show. It's powerful and anointed. In 1 Timothy 2:2, it says that we should pray for kings and all who are in authority so that we can live peaceful and quiet lives marked by godliness and dignity. Why don't you encourage listeners to pray for our president and leaders instead of bashing them?
Mea culpa. I must confess. Well, what you said is exactly right, and we should pray for our leaders. Being a democracy, we are free to bring some criticism when we see the country being destroyed, but again, that we might live a peaceful and godly life. And the truth is that we enjoy peace in this land we're in and a great deal of prosperity. Even though some things are being mismanaged, we're still blessed by being here, and we ought to pray for our leaders. You're exactly right. Thank you.